Welcome back. The hashtag is Game Plan 2017. Our guests tonight, David McCallie and Gujiri Mbogu, thank you so much for making time for us. Edwin Sifuna could not make it tonight, sadly, but he'll be with us next week. Yesterday, ANC leader Musalia Mudavadi gave the strongest hint yet that he's ready to work with CORD. Let's take a look.
Wengine wanasema tushikane, tushikane na CORD na wengine. Mimi nasema sina shida. But it must be negotiations and a discussion ambayo itatuleta sawa sawa ili tuone what are we discussing. Lakini mimi nawaambia, I am ready to play that game.
Very, very interesting, and I'll come to that. But first, let's take a look at the question we are asking you tonight, asking which pair of the CORD leaders you think is best suited for them to win the 2017 election. And these are the scenarios we're looking at, because there is a team by CORD mulling over the best combination or scenarios for the CORD leaders. Let's take a look. There you have it. That is the same one we had last year. Possible scenarios: Raila Odinga or Kalonzo Musyoka, Raila being president, Kalonzo vying for the deputy president position. And then we have the opposite. If Kalonzo was the flag bearer and Raila was the deputy. Okay, what if Kalonzo was the flag bearer and Moses Wetangula the deputy? This is what they're mulling over, the CORD team of six. Trying to get a flag bearer. And the opposite, what if it was Wetangula vying for president and Kalonzo deputy? And what if the ticket again was Musalia Mudavadi, who says now he can work with CORD depending on issues here and there, but he says it's possible. And Kalonzo is deputy, and the opposite again. What if it's Kalonzo president and Musalia the deputy? What if it is Raila and Musalia, or Musalia and Raila? First, let's take a look at what people have been saying about this. What do you think are the possible scenarios, and what do you think will work best for CORD? What have you been saying? Ben Maida, Kalonzo Raila can be the best option. In fact, I think you mean Kalonzo as the flag bearer. In fact, people are just anticipating that, okay? Peterson C says Kalonzo versus Kalonzo Mudavadi, that's what you mean, will give a very good headache to Jubilee, and that will guarantee them a win. Aruga Amos, Mudavadi should work together with Raila to win the 2017 elections. And Lloyd Onyango, Mudavadi should join CORD but with lesser conditions so as to avoid unnecessary complications. Keep talking to us. The hashtag is GamePlan2017. I don't know what you think. Keep talking to us. David McCallie, fast. Musalia Mudavadi's remarks.
Well, I think he was being... you know, in this politics, you cannot rule out any support base. And the natural catchment area for Musalia is obviously the CORD support base, because mm-hmm. the Jubilee support base is sort of locked up. So he has to all the time appear to be looking in their welcoming partnership with the CORD side. And to say the truth, I think there is still some chemistry between him and Raila Odinga, even though they parted in 2013. Mm-hmm. It just depends on how these negotiations or interests develop. I do not see it being easy for Musalia to agree to support Raila. So each one is digging in.
Yeah. Okay. But when you say support base, I don't know if... And it's important to point this out about the scenarios. One day in politics is a long time. Yes. A lot can change. This is... We just look at the possible scenarios. We don't know what will happen by 2017 when you go to the elections. But you're saying support base, meaning he's just appeasing them? Or he may be serious here.
I mean,
joining CORD.
First of all, I don't think Musalia is talking about joining CORD. Working with CORD is one thing. Joining CORD is a different story. Mm-hmm. I mean, I think we need to separate those two. Mm-hmm. And that constituency that CORD commands, the support base that Raila enjoys, was a shared support base in 2007, and so there is still some nostalgic connection there that can be revived any time. And I think the CORD base has never really been hostile to Musalia Mudavadi. So if he comes back and says, let's work out an arrangement, let's negotiate a winning formula, there is possibility that can hang out and can work.
Okay. The
scenarios are very interesting, but I get the feeling that they're very theoretical.
Mm-hmm.
And this is what I mean. First and foremost, I do not see Raila Odinga allowing anybody else to run for president, and it's not just because he wouldn't want to, it's because there's a lot of investment that has gone into the brand of Raila Odinga to where he is today. So it's a situation of, and it's not, he's a captive of his brand, he's a captive of his identity. He's relevant because he's running for president. That's the first thing. The second thing, for example, let's move away from Raila Odinga. If today Uhuru was not running, how many Kikuyus would come out to vote? See, the issue is not that you have, there's the theoretical numbers that are behind you, mm-hmm. but then there's also the fact that the motivation of actually coming out and vote. Most people will come out and vote because of your candidate who you are trying to put your person inside. So we have the Nyanza vote block that is diehard Raila support base. You have the Rift Valley Kalenjin vote block that is Ruto. If these people were not running and you are given and you are told that we are going to support you, so you've been given the vote block, but will they actually wake up in the morning of the ballot day and go and vote? Because they don't have that motivation. You get what I'm saying?
But it hasn't proven before, and it happened.
Which one? Where?
When Raila said Kibaki Tosha, people still
yes.
voted, isn't it?
But you see, there was a deal between Kibaki and Raila, which is what he was selling to his people.
This is assuming, a scenario here is assuming there's a deal that has been agreed upon, isn't it?
But we know what happened in 2002. So the question becomes, so yes, in 2002, we have a precedent that is not very nice. That unless you're the president, any other deal can be thrown out immediately the other guy gets in. That's the problem we tend to have. That I will swear anything if you give me your vote block, but we have precedents, several of them, where MOUs that have been signed before actually don't get honored.
Right.
So it will be very hard for you to motivate your people by telling them that this guy is going to honor it
Do you think what he's saying is right? In terms of people may not vote if it is not...
First of all, what I'm addressing is the possibility of that combination,
yeah.
that it can work. At that level, I'm saying, yes, it can work.
Yes.
As to whether that combination can proceed to an election
yeah.
is a different story.
Mm-hmm.
Because then every combination has consequences.
Yes.
Because what happens to those who are not on the block?
Yes.
On the number one and two, the running mate scenario.
Exactly.
There is the motivational factor. Will people turn out? And what will happen to Jubilee? Will they be coming in to poach and lure those? And two,
that may not be happy.
The last elections, of course, were won on a couple of fronts, including the registered voters and the turnout. So those still
yes.
are factors which will determine actually the turnout, regardless of what combinations you come up with.
In fact, sorry, to
yeah.
just add on to what Makali is saying, that these combinations are not in a vacuum.
Mm-hmm.
That's what he's saying. So
yeah.
every combination, the people who are left out become immediate prey, for lack of another word, for Jubilee. Because you just walk in and say, look... Like now, for example, if Musalia was given the presidential ticket for CORD, and then Kalonzo was given an animate, the first thing you have to convince Kalonzo is, I have been with you through thick and thin. This guy has been out there. Then he comes and you're telling him, you're not even, not only are you not running,
yeah.
I mean, that I was willing to fight,
yeah.
but you're giving it to somebody else. So there's a...
okay, in Kakamega yesterday,
right
yes,
there.
Yes, yes.
Yeah.
But in Kakamega
yeah.
yesterday,
yeah.
Luya leader said they will rally behind one person, if that person is assured to be the flag bearer. That is where Mudavadi was speaking, by the way. That is where Oparanya spoke as well.
Yes.
Wetangula somehow was not
in that
event.
Yeah.
Do you believe that? Do you believe what they're saying can really happen?
There is possibility of that happening, but this needs to be worked out very meticulously. It's a very sensitive issue. I mean, there is Wetangula who is running and really wants to get the ticket. And he thinks that he is more entitled to that ticket because he's been with CORD. And Musalia coming in is like an alien, somebody they have to welcome in and give a position to play, not come in and take the leadership.
And take over.
So there's a sort of entitlement by virtue of, you know, that we have invested. As Wetangula have invested in this coalition, I was there last time, still
mm-hmm.
here.
Mm-hmm.
And so I deserve support. So it's a really serious bargain that they have to confide to Musalia. Musalia has his own merits. He's coming in, he's saying, look, I have my clout, I've run before, I ran last, so I have presidential credentials.
Okay. Pastor Moise, do you think if he's going to work with CORD,
yeah.
on whose terms do you think it will be?
If he's going to, what do you mean on whose terms? I think that it's heavily in the interest of CORD to get Musalia Mudavadi in a working arrangement.
Now, where is that? Okay, finish.
Well, and Musalia, I think, has something to bring on the table. And he's leveraging that in these negotiations. He thinks he has a better If Western is going to produce a candidate, then it's going to be him, because he thinks he has a better spread and better ground support, or he can marshal better than Wetangula, who has been, you know, already launched his bid and he's on the road trying to sell it.
Okay.
So if that happens, yes. and for CORD, I think Western is critical to its mathematics.
Yes.
If he doesn't get it right, then the chances of actually running a successful race are also hampered.
But you see, there's also something we're not seeing. I am convinced that these scenarios are not about winning the election. They're about ensuring there's no first round win. Because you see, if you can consolidate pockets,
that is what you
that's my
think.
Opinion. That you create scenarios, because you can rearrange them. After you have the first round, you can now you now have a situation where you have a much more level playing ground. See, right now, CORD is running against an incumbent who, for all intents and purposes, could just keep playing around and win the first round. But if you stop the first round win, you have created an environment where you can now have a better conversation, better negotiations within CORD, because now the second round looks easier to win than the first round.
I don't agree with that. I think I don't agree. That is a little dicey. I think there is a determination by, you know, both Musalia and CORD to take the ticket and win
as
a first round option, if they can achieve a combination. If, for example, Musalia forges ahead with his own sort of coalition and becomes strong enough as to attract the support of CORD, they think if they back him, they'll take it. That could happen. If along the way, Musalia's front also thinks that, look, this opportunity is not there this time round, let's join forces with a potential a partner with potential victory, it could confer victory, you know, on CORD, if that is a working arrangement.
You see, where I disagree is that the reality of the numbers of our arithmetic. You know, one of the things people have never really faced up to is that 75% of our voting population is in five tribes, five communities. 75%. So for you to win a first round, there are certain communities that must be in your block. And one of them is Kikuyu or Kalenjin. If you don't have these two blocks,
why not Luhya?
This is the problem. You see,
why not Luhya?
Let me tell you now. Let me tell you about the Luhya. The Luhya is not a developed. The Luhya is not a developed political constituency. We are the ones who discuss Luhya as a political constituency. Within themselves, they have a very strong Maragoli Bukusu identity that is at the ground.
But you're talking about numbers, isn't it?
Yes.
You're talking about numbers.
Yes.
So the question is very direct.
Yes.
If the Luhya vote as a block, why not Luhya? Why are you saying only Kikuyu and Kalenjin?
Because you have to get 50% plus one. And the problem is that you can't add, what do you add to the Luhya to get 50% plus one? So you have the Luhya as a vote block. So which is the other community that votes as a block, so that you get 50% plus one?
Okay.
You get where the problem
is?
So you can get the Luhya as a block, and they'll give you 35%. But you still need to get 20%. Where are you going to get it from? There's no other community except the Kikuyu and the Kalenjin who can give you that block.
Okay.
Because
there's a reason why I won't let you get away with that.
Yes.
Because we don't have numbers now.
But we have them on the register.
The registration is going on.
Yes.
We're talking about the 2017 election. Let's see what the numbers will say. And
yes,
that is again basing the assumption that
yes,
people will only vote on tribal lines. They'll vote as a block. All tribes in Kenya will vote as a block. That is the assumption you're making.
No.
That is the assumption you're making.
See, we're doing a theory here. And we're saying, if you're going to do the mathematics, remember we're doing arithmetic to get 50% plus one.
Yes.
So even this arithmetic that we're just doing here, the scenarios are actually communities we're talking about. When you see Kalonzo and Mudavadi, it's communities. It's not, that is the reality of the scenarios.
Okay, suppose you add Kalonzo's constituency as a community and Raila's constituency as a community. Doesn't that have a counterweight to neutralize the two communities? If you add the Luhya.
The Luhya and Kalonzo.
Kalonzo and Raila.
You're going to lose one of those in any of those scenarios.
Arrangements.
Yes. You need one of them.
That is an assumption. Yes.
But again, the reality is.
But I don't want to say
the
sad thing is that people
ethnic
vote.
Arrangement.
Yeah,
yeah.
It's
unfortunate.
And we're really hoping.
It's a factor.
But we're really hoping that we'll end. Let's see what the numbers will be. I'm not talking about ethnic numbers. I'm talking about the numbers of registered voters in the next election. Let's wait for that. Some say Raila stands the best chance if he supports somebody else. His allies say there's so much investment, like you were saying, he's put into this, he can't just let it go to anybody else. they should all fight it out. I don't know what you think.
I think it's true. I mean, Raila has a very huge constituency that is, you know, cross-ethnic. And that, you know, actually, if you ask me, he could command more than one community of support.
True.
Which, if he confers that support, believing it comes along with him, whatever decision he makes, it can confer serious numbers to another candidate. Now, the arithmetic here, the complexity is that there are three players here.
You know? So somebody's going to get hurt.
So somebody's going to lose out unless there is sufficient mechanisms for reaching that candidate ticket that keeps the others in-house. As happened in 2007 when ODM was together and everybody was had the chance to run.
Yes.
Balala, you know, Ruto, and Musalia and everybody. So everybody was content that they had a chance to be the ticket carrier. If you lose in that format, so it's about how they manage that competition and how Raila confers that support to whoever he decides.
But there's also something else, Hussein. Elections are not just about the numbers of voters, it's also about the capacity to raise money, which is now the other factor. That once you now have, for example, Raila has proven that he can actually fundraise as a presidential candidate. It's very difficult. You can mobilize votes for somebody else. It's very difficult to raise money for somebody else. It's very difficult.
I mean, in this case, I think it's possible
for another candidate.
If not
at the same, because remember, the money, and this is the reality of how politics is done, the money that is raised is negotiated. We are going to give you this money, and then you're going to do this for us. Now, we are giving you the money, but this is the guy who is going to do it for us. It is not
It's possible if indeed that negotiation is happening within the same circles, and you're two people, three people are saying, look, fund this team. And obviously, Raila is the most energetic.
Exactly.
And the
one who attracts the most
fundraiser. And he will get. So if he says, I'm part of this team, fund us, because the objective is for us to get to power, what would stop those supporters from giving?
But then what do you offer now? Support. The question becomes this, Makali. So what is it that this candidate would offer Raila for that? What are you going to offer him? So I'm going to make you president, and then you do what?
It's about government. What happened in Jubilee?
It's about forming government.
It's about forming government.
So in Jubilee, they were negotiating two positions. I will mobilize for you. I become deputy president, and you become president.
Yes.
So now you're telling Raila not to be any of these two. So what are you going to give him?
Okay, like we say, that's what then we decide, isn't it? This is based on assumptions. But, of course, this is from a six-member committee set up to identify the best presidential formula for the Cord coalition. And we are getting these scenarios from them, by the way.
Actually,
it's a source from this six-member committee who gave us these scenarios. But like we said, at the end of the day, it is Cord to decide. And still time
one
to...
One day is long in politics.
A day is very long in politics, so things can change. But now we've talked about scenarios, I want to hear from both of you. What do you think is the best bet for them? What pair? What do you think?
That's a difficult question. It's a difficult one to answer. But I think, seriously speaking, a combination of all of them, whichever format they agree, put Wetangula, put Kalonzo, put Musalia, and put Raila together, would be a very difficult, team to beat. And I think the favorite combination, if you ask me, would be one that brings Raila and Musalia together back into one unit.
Regardless of who's the flag bearer.
Regardless of who's the flag bearer, if the other constituents, the other support bases for Kalonzo, Wetangula stay intact.
Okay.
That would be difficult to beat.
Okay.
To beat.
Okay.
The one they have. The one that they went into 2013 with. And for me, I'm looking at this from a...
And with the rest still in the fold?
With everybody. If they had the team they have and then were able to keep the rest in the fold. And now that's where the challenge becomes. In fact, why the reason why this struggle is going on is because of the difficulty of keeping everybody in the fold. If they were guaranteed that you're going to have Raila as a presidential candidate, you're going to have Kalonzo as a running mate, and you're going to keep Wetangula and bring in Musalia, and they would actually run, that would be the strongest. That's the strongest team. The problem is, how do you motivate the rest of the team to stay with? Where Jubilee is knocking on the door and telling people, but you know, us guys can.
Okay,
but what is on the other side of Jubilee either?
Well, at least Jubilee's government.
There's nothing you can't.
Jubilee is already
an
incumbent. It's already an incumbent government.
We'll see how the Jubilee party goes as well. But like we told you, this is for Cord to decide. Let's take a look what you've been saying on Twitter. What do you think is the best pair then for them? Flossie Odhiambo, with Mudavadi and Kalonzo as running mates and Raila as the kingmaker, God will garner the Luya, Kamba and Luo votes. Again, sad how this country we all think about voting along tribal lines, but that is how people vote in this country. Sadly, we hope that will change. Patrick Nall, whichever combination God puts in place, unless they ask their supporters to register as voters, the outcome will be as 2013. MC or Makalo, Kalonzo and Raila can still make it next year, minus Mudavadi. Luyas will still vote for Cord. Let's say either way, that's what he thinks. Isaac Modusi, Kalonzo should take it with either Rao or Wetangula. Cord was born by three. Musalia should come slowly. Okay, and Trauma says, forget Kalonzo and Mudavadi or Mudavadi. None of them can unseat Uhuru. Let Cord nominate Marende and Farham Alim. Okay, everybody. It's free to give the opinion. Thank you so much. Let's do this again next week. And thank you for your feedback. I'm Hussein Mohammed. Keep the conversation going on Twitter. The hashtag is GamePlan2017. Let's meet again on Tuesday, tomorrow actually, Monday special. Good night.